Good morning. Give me a hug. I love you, buddy. Thank you for coming up. Ding, 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 ding. Good morning. Good morning, good morning.
Can't see you.
I'm Sara Brinkerhoff.
Oh, now I can.
Your worship associate for this morning. Can you hear me? Okay, good. Thank you. Feels a little low, maybe. I don't know. Okay. I'm a member of OWLS, Older, Wiser, Loving Souls. And I've had several years of experience with life. Just to let you know, you have to be 55 or years older to join this group. It's an exclusive group. I qualify, so if you're interested, check it out. Yeah, I'm old enough, right, right. And my pronouns are she and her. It's good to see you all here, really good to see you all here this morning. And welcome you to this hour of worship. We come together to share in life's meaning, to grow in care and community, and open our hearts and minds to the sacred truth known by many names. Whatever your heritage, however your history, whoever you love, you're welcome here. This space that we make sacred by our presence is where our doubts, anger, and pain are just as welcome as our joys, our certainties, and our resilience. It's a place where we come to renew our spirits, embrace our community, and life-affirming faith. As a reminder, we are guests of the ancestral land of the Susquehannock people. We make a conscious decision today and in the future to honor and respect this space. If you're with us for the first time, we're especially glad you're here, and would like to encourage you to, if you like, sign our virtual guest book. There's a link in the chat, it's completely safe, and we'd love to support you in your spiritual journey. And if there's anyone online or in the sanctuary who would like to introduce themselves, please do so. We'd like to welcome you. If I miss somebody, let me know, please, tech team. I have one announcement this morning. The UUFHC medicine wheel out back is getting a makeover. We need stones, at least a fist or two, to do this. Please drop as many as possible by the bench out by the wheel. On Sunday, September 25th, after the service, there'll be a discussion and explaining basically the energy of the wheel and how to use it. Then there will be a rededication, which will require physical presence to bless the wheel. Sorry, I don't know if I'm in or out here. At any rate, I'm looking forward to that. We offer our gratitude to everyone who has worked so hard this morning to make this service possible.
The older I get, the more I think. You only get a minute, better live while you're in it, cause it's gone in a blink. And the older I get, the truer it is. It's the people you love, not the money and the stuff that makes you rich. And if they found a fountain of youth, I wouldn't drink a drop, and that's the truth. Funny how it feels, I'm just getting to my best years yet. The older I get, the fewer friends I have. But you don't need a lot when the ones that you've got have always got your back. And the older I get, the better I am. Knowing when to give and when to just not give a damn. And if they found a fountain of youth, I wouldn't drink a drop, and that's the truth. Funny how it feels, I'm just getting to my best years yet. The older I get. Souvenirs and little signs of the life I've lived. The older I get, the longer I pray. I don't know why, I guess that I've got more to say. And the older I get, more thankful I feel for the life I've had and all the life I'm living still.
Welcome. Could I get a welcome back? Hello, hello. All right, good. You're alive out there. I'm J. Sue Henry, and I have 78 years of life experience. I am the facilitator for the OWLS group. If you found these opening words a little strange, that is because in our culture, we don't talk about our age, especially us women, and you would never ask a woman her age, is it? But rather, as a member of the Saging International, who certified me as a facilitator, we take pride in the number of years of life experience, and we frequently make our introductions in this manner. As you have heard, the OWLS group is a select group. You have to have that age of 55 at least, although we've made exceptions, in order to get in. Recently, they advertised us as, instead of loving, they advertised us as lively. And I just want you to know that that does apply to the group. I mean, witness the fact. How many people have an OWL collection of this size? And actually, we're missing some. They flew the coop during the cleaning in the RE section. So if you find an OWL, please bring it to us because we need our OWLS to come back. But these OWLS are a special OWLS because they came from Tom Janikowski while he was cleaning out his parents' home. And he brought light and laughter to our group when he visited from California until he passed over a year ago. We are going in our group to explore various topics, and you will hear them referenced throughout this service. But enough of my advertisement for OWLS. At the end of your order of service, you see the words to cherish the opportunity to listen and reflect silently during the musical offerings this morning. Indeed, they give significant messages we want you to hear. Thank you for coming and being willing to examine a topic of which is importance to all of us. It's also, I'd like to give a special thanks to Will Napton, who's always hiding behind those screens back there, who's had to deal with my questions and my questions and what are we on, and is always a faithful servant, if you will, here with the technology. And also for Greg Fiore, who got this email from me saying, I understand that you will be a player. And I didn't even know what he played. And then he gets another email that says, and do you sing? Okay. And so thank him for, again, putting up with these preparations, and we will be enjoying his music today. Some of you are aware, so I'm just going to give a personal update, that my husband Ron, who's had a problem with falling, had a fall on Monday. And it's not funny, but he had just come out of physical therapy assessment for falls and balance. So we had the fall, and last night we didn't know what to do on a Saturday night, you know, when you've been sitting together through the whole pandemic, and here you are again. So we decided to go visit the emergency room. And so he is doing well at this point, but it's been a challenging week. Beverly Peters will now give our opening.
We come together to celebrate who we are. Each of us are at a different stage of life's journey. The OWLS are elders. As Rabbi Zalman Schlachter Shlomi states, elders are the jewels of humanity that have been mined from the earth, but in the rough, then buffed and polished by the stonecutter's art into precious gems that we recognize for their enduring value and beauty. We sense their radiance in youth, but it requires a lifetime's effort to carve out the multifaceted structure that can display our hidden splendor in all its glory. We will share the insights that give meaning and hope to our lives and contributes to our understanding of the blessings and burdens of becoming an elder. Come, let us learn together of the spiritual journey of aging. Join us for the opening hymn, Just As Long As I Have Breath.
Yes, to life, though with pain I may. Now is the time for our chalice lighting. And I'd like I got a short reading here. As we light our chalice, let us acknowledge the light and wisdom that is within each of us and the flame that shines from our UUFHC community. At times, our own light, when we remember the words of Albert Schweitzer, that at times our own light goes out and is rekindled by a spark from another person. Each of us has cause to think with deep gratitude of those who have lighted the flame within us. Albert was pretty sharp. We express our gratitude for those who have gone on before us. Blessing be. Got a light.
Thank you, Dyrck. Nyla Mueller will share a story for all ages, Star Child. Listen for stages of development in our lives.
I was gone, so if I'm supposed to do something, just tell me.
Get to it, Nyla.
Oh, okay. I guess I'm supposed to be reading the book. It's Star Child. Good. And it's by Claire A. Nivola. And it celebrates the life cycle. And I'm just going to read it here. The star child watched the earth from far away in the sky. He saw the tiny bright swirls of blue ocean and green land turning in the empty cold blackness of space. And he wanted so much to go there. Please, may I go and see what it is like? He begged. His elders said, you are a flame of vapor, invisible and timeless. To visit planet Earth, you will have to be born as a human child. At first, you will have to learn to use your new body, to move your arms and legs, to pull yourself upright. You will learn to walk and to run, to use your hands, to make sounds and form words. Slowly, you will learn to take care of yourself. Here, it is still and peaceful, but there, the colors, sensations, and sounds will wash over you constantly. You will see so many living things, plants and animals beyond imagining. Here, it is always the same, but there, everything is in motion. Everything is always changing. You will be plunged into Earth's river of time. There will be so much for you to learn and so much for you to feel. Pleasure and fear, joy and disappointment, sadness and wonder. In your confusion and delight, you will forget where you came from. You will grow up, travel and work. Perhaps you will have children, even grandchildren of your own. Over the years, you will try to make sense of that happy, sad, full, empty, always shifting life you are in. And when the time comes to return to your star, It may be hard to say goodbye to that strangely beautiful world. Think well before you go. The star child listened, but his yearning was too great. He went, and all that the elders had said was true, for they too had once visited the earth. But ask him now if he is glad he went, and yes, he will tell you, yes. The end.
Thank you, Nyla. Ours is a welcoming community where we find connection, a spiritual community where we find meaning, and a sharing community of our joys that can be amplified and our sorrows that can be reduced. Take a moment, reflect on your joys and sorrows, and acknowledge the mutual support of our community. Now is the time to briefly share a joy, a sorrow or gratitude, something you hold deeply in your heart. A gentle reminder, it's not about announcements, but sharing for someone else is important that you have their permission. Use a microphone, imagine you're a rock star, get right into it, and I'll be here to help if you need with the stand. For those of you on Zoom, please put in the chat that you'd like to unmute, and we'll do that for you. Also note in the chat if you'd like me to do the sharing for you. And I'll probably need tech support on this. So please come forward if you'd like to share. Let's see. Martha Proudfoot will now share a meditation with us. Oh, there she is. She's moved to Delaware, but she came back today to do this meditation with us, and she shares with us on Zoom as well.
Thank you, and I am Marthea. It's a made-up name, not that you asked, but it's my mother's name. Whoops, I need to do this. It's my mother's name, Marthea, no, Margaret, and my father's name, Theodore. So there you go. All right, as Sara said, I do this on the Zoom calls, and we've been doing it for a really long time. And I am grateful that everyone appreciates what I have to offer. I'm going to start out by saying, thank you, Great Spirit and Source of All Being, for our time together here today. We honor the presence and essence of each person here and on the Zoom, and we recognize that this room is now a sacred space designated for worship and healing. Please close your eyes and begin breathing slowly and easily. Inhale through your nose. Hold for a few moments and then exhale through your mouth. Do this a few more times. Give your mind permission to rest and allow all the muscles in your body to completely relax. If you notice tightness or tension in any part of your body, just gently release it and let it go. Continue breathing slowly as you sink even more into a state of deep relaxation, peace, and calm. Now, as you take another breath, feel it coming up from the earth through your right foot, leg, up through your torso, chest, neck, face, and out the top of your head. Exhale slowly down through the right side of your body. Now, as you inhale, Feel the air coming up the left side of your body, through your foot, leg, hips, torso, chest, neck, face, and out through the top of your head. Exhale slowly down the left side of your body, and with your next breath, breathe up through both sides of your body, all the way up and out the top of your head. Exhale slowly down both sides of your body. Breathe in again while sensing that any energies you no longer need are being released gently into the ethers. Using your imagination, picture or sense a large archway a few feet in front of you. It is made of a substance that reflects light in all directions. This shimmering bright light radiates through the archway and outwards, enveloping everything in its brilliant glow. As you gaze through the archway, you can see that the light source is the sun, and although you know it's off in the distance, it illuminates the entire archway. You're thankful that the sun's rays are at the perfect angle, so you are able to enjoy its brilliant reflection without glare. Something about the archway feels like it's beckoning you to walk through it. You feel the urge to accept its invitation, and you begin to take a few careful steps forward. The thought comes to your mind that on the other side of the arch is everything that you need. Thoughts and feelings come to you about what you'd like to experience on the other side of this amazing gateway. You feel completely safe and comfortable, knowing that all you have to do is trust the light while thinking about what you will feel on the other side. Peace, love, healing, purity, joy, wisdom, happiness, hope. Breathe in deeply as you take another step forward, and then another and another, until you've reached the archway. You're standing underneath its glowing shape while allowing yourself to feel its lovely radiance. You feel its light flowing through every cell of your body as it gently shifts anything in your being that feels limiting or out of balance. The archway gently nudges you to move forward again, so you take three more steps. You stop and allow yourself to breathe in all the feelings that you'd hoped you'd experience after walking through the arch. Breathe deeply. Breathe deeply. Enjoy any images, words, or other pleasant sensations that you might experience. This is your sacred place where all is as it should be. You can return to this special place any time you want by closing your eyes and imagining the archway. Peace, love, and healing and all that you need are on the other side of the archway, waiting for you to receive them. All is well. All is well. All is well. It's now time to bring your awareness back to where you are seated, while relishing the peace and the calm that this experience has given you. Take three more gentle breaths. And thank all that is for this experience. Namaste and amen. And so it is.
Thank you, Marthea. Marthea, can't thank you enough, actually. And this is a time for Thanksgiving. We care for one another through our offering to support the mission of this church, to offer our ministries of community care, pastoral care, and social justice. For you on Zoom, there's a link in the chat, and you can make a donation securely by credit card. Our mailing address, if you need that, is on our website at www.uufhc.net. Thank you for helping us reach all who yearn for an inclusive and loving religious community.
I don't need your rocking chair, your geritol or your Medicare. I still got neon in my veins. This gray hair don't mean a thing. I do my rocking on the stage. You can't put this possum in a cage. My body's old, but it ain't impaired. Well, I don't need your rocking chair. I ain't ready for the junkyard yet, 'cause I still feel like a new Corvette. May take a little longer, but I'll get there. I don't need your rocking chair. I don't need your rocking chair, your geritol or your Medicare. I still got neon in my veins. This gray hair don't mean a thing. I do my rocking on the stage. You can't put this possum in a cage. My body's old, but it ain't impaired. I don't need your rocking chair. Retirement, it don't fit my plan. Well, you can keep your seat, Missy. I think I'll stand. An Eskimo needs a Frigidaire. Like I need your rocking chair. My body's old, but it ain't impaired. No, I don't need your rocking chair.
Ain't that the truth, huh? Thank you, Keaton. Okay, a little change in our service here, so I'm trying to catch up with myself. Okay. We have... Yeah, I can't find her in here.
I'm here.
Yeah, she's on there already. You see her? Okay. Janet is going to do a special reading for us today. She has moved to Tennessee, but she joined us on OWLS anyway. Here she is today. Thank you.
Thank you. And the reading is from the book, The Sages Tao Te Ching. And the subtitle is Ancient Advice for the Second Half of Life. The sage no longer strives to make the world a better place. Thus, it becomes better and better. No longer worries about self-improvement. Thus, improves daily. No longer seeks to control other people. Thus, receives love and trust from all. No longer tampers with things. Thus sees all things unfold as they should to take their place in the natural order of life. Don't mistake the sage's serenity for passivity. We have not given up on important issues. That we no longer attempt to change, that we cannot be changed. I'm going to repeat that last sentence. We know now no longer attempt to change that which cannot be changed. We no longer ignore that which can be changed. And we finally have the wisdom to know the difference.
Thank you, Janet, and thank you for everyone else who's been presenting. Made my job easy, didn't it? Well, I've got the message, and you're prepared for about an hour. Is that correct, that this was a special service? Because we older people are known to be a little slower, or so they say. All right. The good, the bad, and the ugly of aging. For indeed is a mix of all of these things. And just as that quote, maybe some, I'm really happy to see young people here, maybe some of them know why Clint Eastwood, what that was all about. Anybody know the good, the bad, and the ugly? I mean, I just always would say it. I didn't know it had meaning. But it did. Well, it references guns of all things, that no two guns are identical or alike despite their model. And that is also the aging experience, isn't it? Now, clearly, socioeconomic, demographics, health status, family structure, etc., 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 all impact on an individual's aging experience and would be multiple topics themselves. Wrap this in our culture, the American culture. Let me just ask, do we value aging in our culture? Oh, we tend to value what? Youth. Youth. So, I would like just to encourage each of you to reflect upon the messages that you have received growing up. And for the young people here, I want you to open your eyes and your ears and start to listen about how we present aging and, quote, old people to you. Because I would like to remind you, you're going to age. Hopefully, you will have the opportunity to grow old. It's an opportunity that many do not get. I also would like to remind you that you're going to die. These are the facts, folks. We can't debate those two facts. So this message is going to look at some of the factors of the importance of how you handle this very special time of aging. Now, an off comment is old age is not for sissies. And this is true. And yet we rarely add on to that comment that it is also the opportunity for what may be your most significant spiritual journey. Do we think about the opportunity that's here? So perhaps instead of the good, the bad, and the ugly, we should think of the blessings, but also the burdens of aging. Now, I must confess, I was not original in thinking of burdens and blessings. I was back with the good, the bad, and the ugly. I stole that from Joan Christner's book, The Gift of Years, Growing Older Gracefully. She states, and I quote, "It is a time for us to let go of our fantasies of eternal youth and our fears of getting older and to find the beauty of what it means to age well. It is time to understand that the last phase of life is not non-life. It is a new stage of life. These older years, reasonably active, mentally alert, experienced and curious, socially important, and spiritually significant, are meant to be good years." Now, I know some of you are going like, it's been a stressful week. She's lost it if she believes that. Okay. But this is part of the paradigm that we're trying to shift. Now, how does this play out with the story that you just heard Nyla read about the various stages of development? My hunch is that many of you here have watched with great anticipation and anxiety as your baby was going to reach each milestone correctly during the first year of life and then later. Is that true? Come on, talk to me. Yep, okay. You may have studied and even considered this in your parenting, the developmental theories and tasks presented by Eric Erickson. Okay, yet he provides such a short description for what is an increasingly longer period of life from age 65 to death. He just says, it's a time of identifying ego integrity versus despair. That's not a surprise about the despair, but I bet you didn't think about your ego integrity. Okay. There's so much more that we get to do at this stage. Our current expansion of resources in this field show that there are a great many developmental tasks, if you will. You thought you were done at this stage. Nuh-uh. You've got more to do, as well as the spiritual growth that I keep mentioning. This is seen in the vision of age made by many gerontologists, which is as follows. You're considered young old from 65 to 74. You're considered old from 75 to 84. When I typed that, I was just like, oh dear, that's where I am. Okay, and you're the oldest old from 85 and over. I did not make this up, it was in the book. I like the way that I heard years ago, and that is the stages, if you will, of aging are go-go, You know, they're the ones you see the advertisements. Slow go, and guess what? No go. So regardless of where your age might put you, our congregation here clearly reflects individuals in all aspects. And I would raise the question for reflection as a congregation, how do we stay connected to those individuals who have moved to the no-go category? Just another thing to think about. Well, overall, it is clear that we have much to do for the research of older folks and the changing culture where we are not just old, but elders. And a conscious elder at various stage. You all know the stereotypes for old. But we also have now more and more models of elders. And I'm not going to get into the politics, but just look at some of our very conscious, vigorous elders that we have in positions of power, all the way to the Pope. It's changing, and you too can be part of this change. Now listen to the words from, I always thought she was just a feminist, but Betty Friedan also wrote a book called The Fountain of Age. And in it she says, development can indeed continue beyond childhood and youth, beyond the 70s. It can continue until the very end of life, given purposes that challenge and use our human abilities. In sum, our development does not necessarily end at any age. We can continue to develop in our 80s and our 90s. Many credit, and I have to give kudos to Bev, who rattled off Rabbi Shachner Shalomi better than I did. I wish his name was Rabbi Smith. He wrote the book From Aging to Saging, which was copyrighted in 1995. He was the beginning, by many folks' understanding, of the spiritual eldering movement, when individuals are asked how they began to examine their concept of aging and their personal comfort with it. I can clearly remember my sighs of relief when I read the book, that there was something more than just growing old. Today we have many books and an opportunity to gain information. The OWLS have been experiencing the process of saging, which I define as a new way of looking at your past life and the end of life so that you can more fully live in your current life. So let's see what the OWLS, who represent all of these stages of aging and will readily acknowledge that they have been blessed in so many ways in their life, what they had to say about the good, the bad, and the ugly. And I'll try to click my phone very nonchalantly and say, okay, speed it up. Okay. So going back to the good, the bad, and the ugly, and that came as a joke as Sara and I worked on the script there. And we couldn't think about what we might be listing underneath ugly. And we thought, well, duh, your physical appearance. I mean, everyone tells you that you are ugly when you get old, okay? And okay, young people, you have to admit, you probably have looked at some of us and said, oh, geez, I hope my arms never get that crepey flying thing in the face hanging down, all of that. Okay, and then what do they show you when they show you older people in the advertisements, particularly women? They show a young woman and they've dyed her hair. That's it, okay. I gotta stop here because I thought I'd come to terms with that, but clearly I have not come to terms with it, okay. So we're not gonna talk about ugly. We're gonna wanna change the image of what really is beauty and that gray hair and wrinkles. As the song said, I don't mind all the lines from all the times I've laughed and cried, souvenirs and little signs of the life I've lived. That's the change we want. You still have them, but it's a different view. So in a very unscientific survey that totally lacks reliability and validity, I asked the owls the question of what is the good, the bad? So let's get rid of the bad so we can end on a positive note. So I'm going to just go through with this, okay? These are the burdens of aging that the owls gave. The top vote, not surprisingly, goes to general health issues, trying to manage physical and mental, and staying healthy becomes harder. A whole list of loss. So I'm just going to read. Losing your mind and personality due to dementia, losing friends to death, losing family members to death, losing mobility, losing independence, losing the abilities to do activities such as skiing and poker, slowing down, lack of motivation, particularly for those routine tasks of life, and taking longer to get things done, the illness of friends. Now, personally, I'm going to start keeping a list because I get confused on who is having what done when and all of that. And you like to be supportive, but the list is so big at this age. Not being as financially secure. Now, we were going to yell out in the offering, wait, don't ask for more money, we're on fixed incomes, okay? Not on the owls list, but many would mention the fear of dying and death. Perhaps it is not on the list of the people who did the survey because of our beautiful experience watching and hearing from one of our members, Sara Morton, known by many in the fellowship, as well as a co-founder of this group, gave us this experience. And we continue to be grateful for the wisdom she shared and demonstrated. So does that list sound familiar to those over 55 in the group here? So the blessings. I'm still mobile. The mind is mostly there. Friendships. Time made available by retirement for reflection on life choices. Not getting angry as easily and making appropriate expression of my anger. Less worry, anxiety, and need to control and greater acceptance. A recognition that my kids are doing the best they can where they are. Often surprisingly happy. Ability to have joint replacements. It's life-changing. Ability to ask for what I need without regret, embarrassment. Appreciate and value my spiritual truth, ability to enjoy nature, can laugh easier, enjoy looking back and seeing how I affected many people's lives, watching grandkids coming into their own beings. This last one's R-rated, and since we've made it sacred ground, but I have to say it, okay? Love life. This may come as a surprise. Love life like a teen, and plenty of time to have fun. Service to others is an integral part, and in the group of owls, I did not ask them for all the places they volunteered, but I know they volunteer many places. You are sitting in a building that was constructed, not totally constructed, but they did construction on this building by Dyrck, and in the back, Glenn, who's back there volunteering, learning this technology. So who says we can't learn technology at this age, okay? And he built that console where all of that technology is. That is giving service. We have lots of service. So I would just simply like to say, and I'm skipping some parts because of time here, that I hope that you can see how we have progressed, what some of the concerns are. So what do you go from here Well, that was nice. We had a few laughs about what aging is about. But I want to encourage you. There's lots of resources. I'm going to be putting, because I didn't get to it this week, a bibliographies out there. There are information from Saging International. We have, in addition to OWLS, we have Barbara Bowman's. See, I'm stumbling, Barbara, because she didn't want me to say all this pronotion, on a group for women living alone. All of this is to help you to become an elder. And I'm going to end with a poem that also describes what it means to be an elder. So this is why you're going to want to do it, because you want to be this person that I'm reading about. Leaving behind my journey of struggling and racing through the white water of many rivers, I became the river, creating my own unique way. Leaving behind my self-imposed role as a tree upon which others have leaned, I now become the wind, with freedom to blow whenever and wherever I choose. Leaving behind the boxes I've created in my life, crammed with roles, responsibilities, rules, and fears, I become the wild and unpredictable space within which flowers sprout and grow. Leaving behind the years of yearning for others to see me as somebody, I soften into becoming my future with permission from self to continually unfold as I choose without concern for how others may see me. Leaving behind years of telling and reaching, I become instead a mirror into which others peer and view reflections of themselves to consider. Leaving behind the urge to provide answers for others, I become, in the silence of this building, the question. And leaving behind the rigor of my intellect, I become a single candle in the darkness, offering myself as a beacon for others to create their own path. I become an elder. So now, let us each let our little light shine in the singing of this little light of mine.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Building up a world, I'm gonna let it shine. Building up a world, I'm gonna let it shine. Building up a world, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Thank you, Greg. I hope you come back many times. Before our postlude and time of fellowship, Glenn Brown is going to share our benediction.
You know, the OWLS group meets the second and fourth Tuesdays of every month. And when we finish our little meeting each time, we've taken hymn number 413 and we've modified it to our own use. And we stand up, we hold our hands together, we look at each other in the eye, and we sing this song. So let's try it now. Will the owls here stand up and help me here now? Okay, here we go. How's it start? Are we ready? Go now in peace. Go now in peace. Everybody. May the Spirit of love surround you everywhere, everywhere you may go. Thank you.
Glenn also shared with us that when the children were going to their rooms, we would sing this song to them. So it's kind of a special song. Let's see.
I'm gonna live till I die. I'm gonna laugh instead of cry. I'm gonna take the town and turn it upside down. I'm gonna live, live, live until I die. They're gonna say, what a guy. I'm gonna play for the sky. Ain't gonna miss a thing. I'm gonna have my fling. I'm gonna live, live, live until I die. The blues I lay low, I'll make them stay low. They'll never trail over my head. I'll be a devil till I'm an angel. But until then, hallelujah, I'm gonna dance. I'm gonna fly, I'll take a chance, riding high. Before my number's up, I'm gonna fill my cup. I'm gonna live, 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 live until I die. The blues I lay low, I'll make them stay low. They'll never trail over my head. I'll be a devil till I'm an angel, but until then, hallelujah, I'm gonna dance, I'm gonna fly, I'll take a chance, riding high, I'm gonna, numbers up, I'm gonna fill my cup, I'm gonna live, 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 until I
amen and hallelujah. Please join us for coffee and fellowship. And for those on Zoom, we will keep the Zoom open for a while, but you're on your own for coffee.